take the wild horse of mind. We become what we think about. This assertion has been stated many times in various ways. Argue for your limitations and they become yours. You are not what you think you are, but what you think you are. Your life is what your thoughts make it. You currently act as you currently believe. The way you define reality shapes it, which in turn shapes and defines you. You behave in accordance with what you imagine to be true about yourself and your environment. You become who you are as a result of your dominant thoughts and desires. All these sayings imply that we converse with ourselves continually. And it is true, our wild horse of mind gallops from one thought to another, judging, questioning, interpreting, analyzing, and deciding. What do you say to yourself? While speaking inwardly, do you evoke misery or joy? Are you creating your own hell or your own heaven? Inner dialogues. The quality of our lives is dependent on the quality of our inner dialogues. Negative mind talk takes many forms. I can't, blank, if only, blank. I don't have enough energy, time, luck, skill, blank. Someday I'll, blank. I wish I had, blank. Yes, but, blank. And I really don't care, it's not important, blank. Over time, these negative self-images begin to dominate our sense of who we are. Defeating or shaming conversations with ourselves constitute an invasion of hostile forces from within. Positive self-talk, on the other hand, awakens inner resources. In these affirmative frames of mind, we become all that we can be. Pathways to Peace, 40 Steps to a Less Violent America by Victor Cuerva, MD, with a foreword by Ashley Montague. Mental endurance develops through composed thinking. Workouts include problem solving, brainstorming, gathering information, memorizing, and concentrating. To test your mental endurance skills, try to count in your head the number of capital letters composed of curved lines. Mental coordination would be impossible without the regular use of imagination and visualization. These faculties of mind give way to new possibilities, including innovative patterns of behavior. Using imaginations, you can edit and direct your own mental movies. Visualization can assist you in seeing the future as you want it to be. By filling your mind with positive images and mentally rehearsing desired outcomes, you will be able to accomplish tasks with ease, and you will be liberated from the old attitudinal prisons of your own making. Just as correct physical posture aligns the body with gravity, proper attitudes align the mind with truth. While tending to your attitude, replace destructive, inaccurate thoughts with affirming, honest, and constructive ones. Whenever an answer is beyond reach, say, "I don't know," three empowering words that invite possibility. See with your mind, not merely your eyes. And when trying to remember something that has slipped your mind, say, "It will come to me soon." Then let go of the search. The request for stored information will soon be answered. A fit mind, like a conditioned body, possesses strength, flexibility, endurance, and coordination. Its strength comes from awareness. Aware of your inner dialogues, you will learn from them and begin responding intelligently to new situations. Oblivious to your self-talk, you will allow the wild horse of mind to kick inner turbulence into your external environment. The flexibility of the fit mind is established through attention, and a faculty that recalls and anticipates, sashaying through the past, present, and future in a dance that gives perspective and continuity to life. To stay mounted, you will need to focus your attention in an effortless, relaxed way, which is best achieved through relaxation and meditation. Relaxing your body, breath, and mind will clear the lens of awareness. Meditation, an ideal vehicle for quieting the chatter of thoughts, permits inner wisdom to emerge. Mental endurance develops through composed thinking. Workouts include problem solving, brainstorming, gathering information, memorizing, and concentrating. To test your mental endurance skills, try to count in your head the number of capital letters composed of curved lines. A is not. B is. B. C. D. G. J. M-N-O-P-Q-R-S. T. Skip T. U. V. Skip V. Skip W. Skip Y. Skip Z. W. So it's right for W. T. U. U. And V is the last where it stops. And then V till the end.